Well, when it comes to math facts, they happen to be one of the most boring things to learn. It's important to be very targeted with what you're teaching. You want to remember that in order to trigger neuroplasticity or to learn, the brain needs to be provided with very specific, targeted input and have it delivered with sufficient frequency, intensity, and duration. Unfortunately, a lot of the math fact programs that are out there, they work on a whole bunch of facts and don't target specific ones. So you first want to figure out what your child knows and what they don't know. You take those facts that they don't know, maybe only isolating a few at a time, and use whatever activities create intensity, whether it be flashcards or math fact apps on your iPad or your phone, math websites, anything like that that would create intensity for your child, and focus on just those facts that they don't know. If you have isolated facts that you know they don't know, try throwing those out throughout the course of the day while you're in the car or while you're at the grocery store, and really work to get them into long-term memory. It's important to provide a lot of goals and timelines. For example, when one of my boys needed to learn their 8 times tables, I had a $20 bill that I just stuck on the fridge, and I gave him a certain length of time that he needed to master those math facts, and then he earned that $20. If what you're doing is working and your child is learning them, okay, learning those math facts, then continue on. If they aren't learning them, then it is time to reassess what you're doing and do something different. You don't want to just let them continue working on a particular website for weeks that then turns into months and they haven't learned anything. So be very mindful, be very goal-oriented to produce change and get those math facts nailed.